Hi, this is Chris Massey. I'm a product engineer with Advanced Cooling Technologies, and I was asked, how do your ECUs work? Well, first I got to tell you, what is an ECU? An ECU is an environmental control unit. So in layman terms, it's essentially just an air conditioner. And it's very similar in how it operates to basically any air conditioner you had seen with a DX or direct expansion type refrigerant circuit. So what I'm going to talk about today is a very idealized refrigerant cycle. And the components of the cycle are a compressor, a condenser coil, an expansion valve, and an evaporator coil. So the first step that we're going to start with here is the compressor. So if I show you over here in my little chart that I built, this is a pressure versus enthalpy table. Enthalpy is essentially the heat that's packed into the working fluid, being a refrigerant at this time. So the compressor leg of this journey here starts at this point, and this point is on a line, which is actually the saturation line. So at this line, you're basically right at the beginning where everything's going to start to evaporate and become a vapor. At this point, at this side of the line, that's where everything is basically in a vapor state, but has not changed in temperature from across this. So this is a one temperature across these. So at this point, this is where the compressor is going to kick in. So it's we're going to be bringing in a liquid, or I mean a saturated vapor. It's going to compress it down, and it's going to add a little bit in the enthalpy. So you're going to end up with a superheated vapor at this point. So this superheated vapor then is fed through your refrigerant lines, and we'll get to the condenser coil. So what's gonna happen at the condenser coil, and these are what you see outside your house, where you might have leaned over and pretended you're Darth Vader as a kid. So it's gonna have a big fan, it's gonna blow air across that coil. This coil will be hotter than the outside environment. So some of that energy, which energy always wants to go from a state, a high state of energy to a lower state. So the energy will move off of the coil with the help of the fan and everything else, to kind of maximize that energy flow, but it's going to flow off of the coil into the environment around it. So once we get it down, through the coil, what we're going to be doing is riding this little line here, and that's going to bring it back to a saturated liquid. So we're still same temperature because we're only dealing with phase change at this point. So we'll send this saturated liquid around to the expansion valve. So what an expansion valve does essentially is it's got an orifice in it, and it kind of holds back the refrigerant flow. Similar to if you've ever been stuck in traffic on a highway where they have a lane closure, right? You can think of this as where the lane is closed. Everything back here is where all the cars are, just piled up waiting, trying to get through. And, as you get through this, you kind of hit that sweet spot just after, and everything kind of opens up, and you got space between the cars, and everybody's flowing and moving great. It does kind of the same thing with the refrigerant. So on this side, we have, a high pressure, basically saturated liquid across the expansion valve. You're going to see it move down from that saturated liquid to a lower pressure mixture. So it's going to be kind of in between, being a liquid and being a vapor. Some of the molecules will be in vapor form, some will be in liquid form. So we're going to take that mixture, and we're going to take it over to our evaporator coil. Now, this is what you would have inside the house, where, it would be in your basement or wherever it's located. That would be the cold coil that the air is blowing across. So because it's colder than the environment that it's in, energy is going to want to flow from the environment into that coil, and it will get absorbed by the working fluid, which is the refrigeration, our refrigerant at this point. So with the help of the fan, once again, to try to maximize the amount of energy flow, that heat energy is going to get pulled back into the fluid. And this is shown by this little leg of the journey here, where it's going to evaporate, which is what I call the evaporator coil. It's going to evaporate that working fluid, the refrigerant, off until we get to the point where it's a saturated vapor, where basically all of the molecules have become a vapor state, but we haven't seen any real temperature change at that point because it's been absorbing the energy and doing the phase change thing. So, and that's what gets carried back around to the compressor. Now, there's some things that, are done and to control it at, partial loads and stuff, such as a hot gas bypass. We use quench valves with that. We can also use unloader valves. And I think that is a little too in-depth for what we're doing today, so you can look forward to some more videos on those topics. Thank you very much. Have a great day.